track and we saw what needed to happen mechanically to optimize our movement and to avoid this dreaded hip flexor pain. Now we're going to show you how to strengthen up the system so that the hip flexors work less and the glute hamstring works more. So go ahead and lay on your back. This is one of my favorites for activating the glute hamstring complex. And this is essentially a bridge exercise with a little bit of an unstable surface, so you have to work a little bit differently. So you're gonna pick up into a bridge, all right? You're gonna straighten out this right leg for starters, and it's gonna be at the same height of this other knee. And you're gonna simply go up and down in your bridge, keeping this leg straight. So all the way to the ground and all the way back up. And you can't cheat this one. It's gonna use this glute hamstring. Now imagine that this was Mary's ski on this foot. And can you see as she pushes up with the left side that her ski essentially slides forward? So that's how you get the slide of that forward ski, is by pushing with the leg that's on the ground doing the backstroke. So the next exercise that we've chosen to really power up this glute hamstring complex is called a standing split squat. So you're just gonna use a surface behind you. It could be a weight bench or a chair or some sort of table, but go ahead and stand, Mary. And you're gonna kick one leg back and you're just gonna put the top of the foot back on the surface. And the back leg is just really there for balance. It's not doing the work. You're gonna descend into a squat on this front leg and you're gonna just try to keep your trunk in line with the angle of the back leg. So you don't wanna be super upright and you don't necessarily wanna be really bent, just nicely in line with this back leg angle, and then go ahead and lower into that squat and come back up. And the more you fold here, the deeper you can go. All right, so another place that our hip flexors get really used is during our kick turn transitions on the skin track. So I'm gonna show you guys a way to use your body and strengthen the setup so you can do that a little bit more efficiently. So we call this drinking bird. So Mary's gonna do this hip flexion action, but she's really using the back leg that's being picked up as the mover. So both legs, since you have this band around your ankles, are working, this back leg that's picking up and the standing leg. See how low you can go in your hinge. Once you get to the max distance of your hinge, she's gonna pulse 5 times into the band. This teaches you to pick your ski up from the backside and control the effort in that standing leg from the backside too. So you're really not using your hip flexors very much for that kick turn transition. Yeah. Another exercise to strengthen up our hips to offset the hip flexors is one we call monster walk. So the same band that you use for that drinking bird exercise, just keep it around your ankles. Could be a lighter version to medium resistance. And the monster walk is where you keep everything pretty level through your hips, through your trunk, and you're just gonna do these little side steps. So she's gonna step out with left and step two with right, step out with left, keeping toes pointed straight ahead. The tendency if you're a hip flexor person is gonna wanna be to kick up and use your hip flexor to do this. But instead, if you kind of keep almost pigeon-toed and you just do these little side steps and you lead with your heel, you'll actually use your side hip muscles instead of the hip flexor for this. All right, so we've done all this good kind of glute ham strengthening, side hip strengthening. Final thing we're gonna do is a nice stretch for the hip flexor group. And there's a bunch of muscles that end up flexing our hip. This stretch kind of lengthens all of them. It's really nice. So if you have a wall or a bench, you'll see the setup. You can use whatever works for you, but you're gonna put one knee on like a squishy bolster or pillow. Get in nice and close to the surface behind you. If it's a wall, that's pretty easy. And then you just kind of tuck your tail a little bit, square up your whole trunk right over that stretching leg, and then just sit back actually into that stretch. So it should feel like the whole quad gets stretched all the way up into that front, kind of front pocket zone. And then if you want, you feel comfortable, you can stretch both arms up. You can grab your left wrist for a little side body stretch too. All right, Mary, so you just got in touch with your backside, right? So we can offset all the work we do with our front side. What do you think?
I think it'll be really helpful out on the skin track. Yeah, it's nice to be able to use some other muscles besides just the hip flexor, not feel like you're just dragging your skis up the skin track. And I think it'll feel a lot more balanced out there.
Cool.